I'm sure you guys have your own favorite place to go. Go for a walk, spend some quiet time with God, and just get in the great outdoors. And I love this little place here in the New Forest, right on the edge of Tiptoe, and this stream that cuts through the forest. And I've been here many a time, sat on this grass, reading the Bible, kind of dreaming dreams, thinking about stuff, praying, coming down here with the kids. It's a real favorite place of mine. And one of the reasons for that is because of this stream, and it just speaks to me of rest. It speaks of quietness, and it kind of speaks to me a bit of what I think the Sabbath really means. You know, right at the beginning of the Bible, God created the earth, the heavens, the fish, the birds, the animals, all these things, the incredible creation around us. And then it says on the seventh day, God rested. And then Jesus picks this up in the Gospels in Mark, where he says, you know what, the Sabbath was made for man. It was put in place for you, to help you. And I wonder in our modern culture that we've lost something of that. We have the crazy busyness of our lives and the things that are demanding time from us and energy. We've got to be here, we've got to be there. And then on the other hand, the kingdom of God is saying, just make sure you have time of rest. Make sure you have a Sabbath. Make sure you pull away and come away with me sometimes. You know, Jesus himself did that, didn't he? He had times after he'd ministered to people and he just came away and had some quiet time with the Father. And I want to encourage you to have a time of rest. I was reading a book a few weeks ago called Crazy Busy, a mercifully short book about a really big problem. And I want to encourage you to find those moments of rest. Don't feel guilty about taking rest, but find a place where you can enjoy rest and Sabbath. And I really believe, and I've found it in my life, that when you work from a place of rest, you're more productive, you honor God, and you worship him. So make sure you take some time out at the start of this year, in this month. Maybe find a little place that you can come to and have that Sabbath rest so that you may live from that place of grace and not from a place of duty, but from a place of delight.